Hello. This is your favorite personal child specialist, Dr. Gaurav Gupta. And today, I have a surprise. I have a special guest, Dr. Poonam Gupta, who is an eye specialist. And she will be talking to us about spectacles in kids. Oh, I forgot to ask. Just tell you that she's also my wife and she practices in the same location at Chara Clinics in Mohali. So Dr. Poonam Gupta, just wanted to say hi to you.
Hi, Gaurav.
So, Poonam, let's just talk about a very simple topic which creates so much anxiety in our Indian parents, and that is spectacles for young kids. So, what are the challenges that you face?
You're right in saying this is the most commonest problem which parents come with. The first challenge is the parents always come late. So there's a big phobia that my child should not wear specs. So first, even if the child is comparing since the last 6 months to 1 year, or they're getting feedbacks from the school, so they come late. When they come, they always are sitting with the bated breath, hovering over the child that he or she should be able to read the last line. And then they try to convince me, no, he is a naughty child, so that is why he is not reading.
Okay, so there's a lot of anxiety in parents.
Yeah. Lot of anxiety regarding spectacles. And once the child gets spectacles, after, you know, me distributing tissues to the mothers who shed a few tears, so I then make them understand that wearing spectacles is actually good, because your child's sphere of vision is restricted, one, and whatever the child is seeing is very blurry. So all right. The parents, they want the best for the child. Somehow spectacles, according to them, is not good. But I always tell them, try to convince them that once the child starts wearing spectacles, he or she will improve in their studies, in their sports, in the extracurricular. And you know what, funnily enough, Gaurav, I tell them your example. I tell them, when you got your spectacles, you were so happy, ecstatic. You were like jumping around, and that's what you told me when you were, I think, 12 or 13 years old.
No. So I need to tell the story to all the parents. My father is a pediatrician, right? And we were going in on this train from Agra to Delhi, and this was at 7 p.m. in the evening, and I'm looking out of the window. And I'm looking at this big billboard sign, and I'm telling dad that I can't read, what is it? And he's shocked, because it's a very big sign and it's fairly close. And he's telling me, you really can't read this. And I'm saying, no, I can't. And then we go to the eye specialist when we go back to, you know, to the hospital. And then I have a really big number. I have like something like 2.5, and I'm in fifth class, so maybe 10 years or so. And my mom is a little upset about the whole thing. And I'm very, very happy, yes, as you correctly said, because I love the specs. It really means that I never thought I could see this clearly. I just thought my whole world was restricted to 3 or 4 feet. And as you correctly said, now I could see for, you know, meters and kilometers, sort of. So it's really a big thing for me, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's right. You know, you have to think from the child's point of view. The child's life will improve. And if we keep on putting this negative feedback in the child that specs is something wrong, so one, they will stop hearing it, or they will develop an inferiority complex.
Right? Yes, so, because the, yes.
Right. So that is what I keep on telling the parents. You should be happy. You know, you're utilized early and the child will improve. And the second example I always give them is mine. On my paternal side of family, everybody has specs. There are nobody who didn't have specs. Right. So for us, it was a very normal thing. The parents used to keep a watch, and the moment they felt there's something wrong, they used to take us to the eye specialist and get the specs done. So I got my spectacles a little late.
Right.
And because of that, my cousins did not play with me because they felt there's something wrong with her because she doesn't wear specs. And the day I got my spectacles, I was so happy. I was so happy that I'm part of the gang. So it's all your, you know, thought process, your own thought process, which is reflected on the child. And most importantly, the child has to wear specs always. There's no concept of, you know, wearing it only while studying or watching television. because as long as our eyes are open, we are using our vision. Hi, Gaurav.
I really wanted to know, how do you motivate children to wear spectacles?
That's a very tough one, you know. It's easier to give specs to kids who are, you know, 2.5 or 3 years old, because they accept it very easily. And for, you know, children who are in their teens, because they understand the importance of wearing spectacles.
Okay.
It's a little
teenagers are comfortable with spectacles, I thought yeah, they would be having.
No. You don't understand, you know, the motivation factor. Because there are so many branded spectacles, lens guard, Gucci, so they like flaunting, you know, I'm wearing this brand. Kids are very brand conscious in that age. So it's somehow easier for them to, you know, wear spectacles.
Okay.
But the tougher age is between 5 to 10 years. Because okay. That is a time when you cannot explain to a child why it is important for their vision development to wear specs. And two, they are teased by their friends, or, you know, they are they get a lot of peer pressure from their relatives, because in India it is felt that something is majorly wrong if a child is wearing spectacles. So what I normally do is, after convincing the parents that they do not have to blame the child for their vision problem, ask the child what is their favorite color.
Okay.
And then I, you know, try to motivate them. Oh, wow, blue. That's mine too. So why don't you get a beautiful spectrum of blue colors? You know, you can get a beautiful Disney spectacles with the characters on it. And, you know, when you go next day to school, and if your friends ask, you can easily tell, wow, I'm wearing a very nice, beautiful spectacles. So that is how I try to motivate them with the colors. And I always tell them, you look so... I tell the parents to, you know, encourage the child to say, wow, you're looking very smart. You're looking very handsome. So that somehow helps.
Yes. Okay. So once you have convinced the children to wear spectacles, what about how long should they wear the spectacles? Because you keep on hearing that wear them during the studies, wear them during, you know, XYZ while watching television. Is that really true?
Common question, because it's not the kids, it's the parents. They have this thing in their mind that if they can reduce the hours of wearing spectacles, that will be better. Because somehow they don't feel the kids need the spectacles. They feel the child will get used to the spectacles, in the habit of spectacles. So we want to break the habit. But, you know, parents need to understand, as long as our eyes are open, we are using them. We are not using them only while in school or watching television. So as long as the eyes are open, I tell the parents, for kids who are using specs for the first time, that you gradually, in a, you know, span of 3-4 days, like first day the child can wear it, the specs for 3-4 hours, next day for 6-8 hours, and from the third day, as long as the eyes are open. So only while sleeping or bathing the child should remove the spectacles.
Okay, lovely. I think most of the common questions have been answered. Finally, I would just like to know, what are the problems if a child does not really wear spectacles? Because you keep on hearing that, you know, when he's 16-18, we get a LASIK done and remove the spectacle number. So why does the child really need to wear spectacles when they're 5-10 years old?
Yeah, like the most, you know, obvious reason is the vision of the child is compromised. So whatever the sphere of vision the child is seeing is small, and that is blurred. So for the child to have a normal vision, he or she needs to wear spectacles. And if they don't wear, a lot of them end up, you know, with headaches, eye strains, you know, those kind of problems. And if a child is less than 8 to 10 years of age and has a correction but is not wearing them, they might land up with something called vision suppression. Our normal vision is 6x6 or 20x20.
Okay.
So if the child is not wearing spectacles, the development of vision stops. And even if the child becomes an adult, he or she won't be able to read the last line or have a normal vision. So most importantly, to maintain your normal vision, the child needs to wear spectacles.
Yes, and then he probably cannot join the armed forces and things like that, where a merchant navy, where you know you require
You're right. That's what I tell, you know, most parents. I say, even if, you know, we all aspire our child to top in, you know, studies and everything. So if, for example, your child tops all over India in all the colleges, you know what happens? Your child will go to the college, they go through a medical checkup, which includes an eye checkup also. So if the child is not, his or her vision is compromised, so despite being the topper, they might not get admission.
I think that will make sense to Indian parents.
Yeah, it does. Then immediately they, you know, are, yeah, you have to wear specs, you know, they start telling the child.
So it was really great talking to you, Poonam, and we'll definitely connect over so many other pediatric eye topics over the next few podcasts, and we will post this on YouTube as well.
Same here, Gaurav. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Thanks. Just keep on sharing, listening, and letting everybody else know that this podcast and this YouTube video exists. And we'll be back soon. Take care. Bye-bye.